Is CS50 the best course to level up your career? Well, CS50 will teach the fundamentals of computer science and give you a Harvard certificate for free. In this video, we're gonna check out whether it's actually worth completing to land a job, and I found lots of good stuff, but there's also a few things I'm skeptical about. It's not about the money here, but rather your time. So we're gonna look into whether it's actually worth spending your time on this course, and here's the plan. I'll start with a quick overview highlighting the essential details about the certificate, and then we'll go over the weeks and tools, discussing each week and what you're gonna learn. Next, we'll move over to the pros and cons, examining the advantages and downsides of this program. Finally, I'll share my personal recommendation on whether it's worth investing your time in the certificate or not. CS50 is a self-paced, entirely online course designed to provide a solid foundation in computer science. You learn a lot of useful stuff, which we'll get into in a second. This course is equivalent to the one offered at Harvard campus, where the students pay tens of thousands in tuition fees every year, but you get it for a very low price, and you can even go through the material for free, which is pretty cool. The course runs for 12 weeks with a recommended study time of about 10 to 20 hours per week. Upon completion, you'll receive a 100% free certificate from Harvard, with an option to obtain a verified certificate from EDX for a small additional fee. Furthermore, CS50 isn't just a standalone course. It can also be taken as part of a professional certificate program, allowing you to combine it with one or two additional specialized courses for a more comprehensive learning experience. I really like that there are different certifications, and I think that it can be really helpful, especially because unfortunately a lot of people have this free certificate, like over 1 million people have enrolled in this course. So I'm not exactly sure how valuable the certificate really is, unfortunately. That's why it's really interesting that they have the professional certificates, where you can specialize a bit and separate yourself from the rest. It's up to you, of course, and a bit more expensive, so consider your budget for that. Okay, so now let's just quickly go through the weeks and what you're gonna learn, and then we'll get into all the details. Okay, so this is how the certificate looks when you're on the page. We're currently in EDX, and as you can see, this is their system. Now, everything is available here. We have the dates, discussion, FAQ, progress, syllabus, and also what's new. We're gonna get into the syllabus, and I'm gonna show you this. So this is the official page for CS50, and as you can see, we have the syllabus, expectations, and some other cool stuff. Now, they're just gonna be expecting you to do a few problem sets, submit a few labs, and then final project at the end. As you can see, it's free. You will get a free certificate if you do complete it, but if you wanna get a verified one, you will have to pay on EDX. I think it's definitely worth paying for, but you can also get it for free. Now, more specifically, what you're gonna learn, week 0 is gonna be Scratch, so 11 weeks, first week is gonna be Scratch, C, arrays, algorithms, memory, data structures, Python, SQL, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, Flask, and Emoji. And it will be pretty intense. Now also some kind of cybersecurity thing, and as you can see, we can also click on the seminars, final project, and here's the final project. You will be able to develop one yourself in the end with the new skills that you have, and that's gonna be pretty cool. It will be a little bit guided, so don't worry about this at all at the moment. And also this is how the actual certificate looks. If you get the free one, if you do get the paid one on EDX, you will get a verified one that looks a little bit more professional, but this one looks really good. Throughout the 12-week CS50 program, you'll get hands-on experience with a variety of programming languages and tools. You learn the basics of C, a powerful and widely used language that forms the foundation of understanding for more complex languages later on. As the course progresses, you'll explore web development by learning HTML, CSS, and even JavaScript, which are essential for creating dynamic and interactive web pages. Additionally, you'll gain exposure to Python, a versatile and beginner-friendly language popular in various fields such as web development, data analysis, and also artificial intelligence. Beyond programming languages, CS50 will introduce you to essential tools like version control with Git and GitHub, as well as concepts like algorithms, data structures, and how software engineering basically works. Now let's get into the pros and cons. Firstly, the course offers a lot of hands-on experience with practical assignments and projects, giving you the opportunity to apply real concepts to the real world. That is very important, and it's gonna be very helpful when looking for jobs later. I also really like how it's available for free with an optional upgrade so that everyone can learn no matter your financial situation. Even if you don't pay, you will get a certificate directly from Harvard, which is pretty cool. I mean, it's one of the world's top universities. It's also a course that have existed a long time. For example, even Mark Zuckerberg held a guest lecture like 15 years ago or something.
I don't know if this stuff is interesting to you guys at all, I mean, if this is anything that, like...
So it's definitely been a while. I also really like that they introduce you to a lot of different programming languages, and then you can specialize later. There is a downside to this though, since you'll need to learn different programming languages, and there's no way that you'll become job ready or some kind of expert at any of these languages. So yes, if you do want to keep using these languages, you will need to study more, and that kind of sucks because it will take more work, but also, like, I like how they introduce you to multiple programming languages so that you can choose what you want to focus on later on. So I think it's both good and bad, in my opinion. Another issue is that for some people it might be a little bit too fast fast-paced. While they don't expect you to have any experience in programming, it's definitely not the easiest course, and it's not supposed to be. It's freaking Harvard. So yes, it might be a little bit hard for some people. You will be able to get through it, but just keep this in mind if you're not really a computer person. While CS50 provides a solid foundation in computer science, it's essential to remember that it might not be specialized enough for some career paths, and to become more specialized and more proficient in programming, I recommend taking one of the CS50 professional certificate programs, such as the one focused on Python or the one focusing on web development. By enrolling in a CS50 professional certificate program, you will not only gain a strong foundation in computer science, but also develop specialized skills in your chosen area. This approach will help you stand out from the crowd, as many people have taken CS50, but not that many people have taken the professional certificates. Although, of course, pursuing these certificates may not be free, and if you're on a budget, you should just take the basic CS50 course for free and then continue learning programming through, for example, free courses on Code Academy or some other free resource. This way, you can build the foundational skills you've acquired in CS50 without breaking the bank. Whatever you do, the most important thing is to get started, so I put all the links in the description. Good luck with CS50, and if you enjoyed the video, then I think you'll like this video too.